My 30s was repaying the mistakes of my 20s. Now in my 40s, it's like, okay, all this stuff settled down. Now I know what to do. At least for me. If I had somebody better in my life and I was, you know, had my head out of my ass, I would have experienced it at 30.
Yeah.
We're having dinner. I said, PBD, I said, I want to start social media. I want to create my brand. I want to create a niche. And he told me this, I want you to find a way to go deep so you can go wide. So let's find you a deep category you can go into. Because I've always noticed every time you teach and train, you always reference the Marine Corps. I'm like, yep, I do. Well, let's look at a veteran entrepreneur. You Googled it, like millions and millions of hits a month were on veteran entrepreneurs. Boom. And there's not one brand that's consistently showing up on Google or on YouTube. Go on your YouTube app right now. You type in veteran entrepreneur. I'm curious, what do you find? Mark Cuban, right?
Yes, Greater Project, Brian Zimmerman, Matt Sapaula.
There you go.
Why veterans make great entrepreneurs.
Boom.
And then you're right back on there.
So I have multiple videos. So that's what I'm talking about. So eventually, my videos will start ranking a lot higher. They're there, so they're sprinkled in the top 20. That's the benefit of a mentor, man. And the mentors, they see more in you than you see in yourself, majority of the time. You know, Patrick said something pretty profound one time. He said, Matt, I don't care anymore to be right all the time. Like, somebody was arguing with me on social media. I hit him with an answer because I had to be right. But after that, I just let him win. I know my truth. And I don't have to prove to you publicly that I know my truth or what the truth is. I state my facts. Boom. I state my facts and I leave it at there. Everything else is opinion. I didn't care anymore to be the smartest person in the room, because that's what all agents want to be. They want to be the smartest person at a Chamber of Commerce meeting. They got to be the most smartest technical expert on the subject matter. That's how we got business. Like, for example, one of my designations is a Certified Senior Advisor, a CSA. I mean, do you even see that on my website? Matt Sapaula, CSA. I mean, I got it. It's not a college degree, but it's a financial certification that says I have studied specific senior citizen gerontology, Medicare, Medicaid issues, and have a specialized knowledge in retirement planning. That's what that designation was. I didn't care anymore to be the smartest person. I want to be surrounded by the smartest people in the world. And I didn't care anymore that I didn't have the answers to everything. I would be the one bottlenecking my success. Like, do I want my definition of success to go through the route and the journey of having to be the smartest person in the room? Or do I want to be the wealthiest person in the room because I got there through a system? I had a better shot at being at a system because I have no patience to go back to school. I have no patience to always have to be right all the time. So I took what made us successful and dumbed it down for the Four Homes of Money. That's an example of that. The three textbook, that's an example of that. To take a complex subject, making it simple, because then the brand new person can run with that. Like, you closed business today.
Yes.
I wasn't even there. You know what I'm saying? If he can figure it out,
right,
everybody can figure it out.
You got it.
For me, when I made my first $400 check, mm-hmm, I was fired up. You know why? Because $400 was literally half of my full-time military check. My military check was $850. 2 weeks, sergeant in the Marine Corps. And next thing you know, I make $400 part-time in business as an entrepreneur, as a salesperson. I'm on to something.
Right.
Nobody ever educated them about the basic fundamentals. We drew the financial house. Insurance is the foundation. Savings is the wall. Your investments is the roof. You know what he said? I've been putting too much towards the walls and the roof. I don't have a foundation. So when the financial hurricane comes in, when the financial earthquake comes in, something for a lot of people has to smack them upside the head for them to actually pay attention and do something about the situation. Sad part about life. And it happened to me. I mean, the reason why I can say that was me. You should do this. Whatever. They did, whatever. My 30s was repaying the mistakes of my 20s. Now in my 40s, it's like, okay, all this stuff settled down. Now I know what to do. At least for me. If I had somebody better in my life and I was, you know, had my head out of my ass, I would have experienced it at 30.
Yeah.
But I got to learn the hard way. From what I've been told, I can qualify for 60, 80% disability if I'm going through a combat environment, dealing with PTSD and all that type of stuff. I can qualify for a good chunk of disability benefits. I refuse to. Because my thank you to the government has given me an opportunity to be in the military. And my thank you for the government is thank you for allowing me to be in a country where I can actually enjoy some of the freedom I fought for.
Yeah.
That's my thank you to the government. Listen, let me bust my ass and stay out my way. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
You know, in other countries you can't do that. Remember, who you're talking to, what you're telling them, and how often you're talking to them. So if you're only talking to 5 people a day, imagine the person that talks to 10 people a day. That person does in one day what it takes you 2 days to do. What about the person that does 20 conversations a day. So they get done in one day what it takes you 4 days to do. So the other is just doubling up on activities initially.
When you start getting into the referral market, oh, that's when it's sweet.